Ladies and gentlemen, that was our first half. Did you enjoy the short form? Well, get ready for our long form. Let me get my whole cast up on stage. Give it up for House Party! As soon as the music hits, Eddie.
Sorry about that.
I said, please give it up for House Party. Some short form games. We're now going to do long form improv, which we're going to get a word from you guys. We are going to tell, I know, totally aware. We're going to give a monologue based on that word, and then we're going to do some scenes for you. And the scenes will evolve from there, either going back to the monologue or that first scene and keep expanding little ideas, little nuggets. And we are going to break the fabric of reality and go all over the place. But we're joined right now by a very special friend of mine. He just headlined LOL tonight. He is there tomorrow as well. Give it up for Moses Storm! Moses is touring right now. He is an awesome stand-up. Please go check out LOL tomorrow if you can make it. Are the tickets still available?
Yeah, they are still available. There's two shows tomorrow, 7:30 and 9:30. Yeah, online.
So, like I said, we're going to do what's called a montage for you. It's going to be a bunch of different scenes, a bunch of different characters, and fun. To get started, we're going to give you a monologue that will inspire all of that. Can I please get a word, any word at all, that's not food?
Jews.
Jews.
Juice.
Juice.
Oh.
Juices.
Oh. I heard juice.
Not food or a drink. Peacock. Any
I don't know how many of you, by round of applause, have ever heard a peacock scream. If you have not heard a peacock scream, I'm going to take you back to when I was like 14, 15 years old. I lived out in the country on the south side of San Antonio. Right, and occasionally you hear a train or coyotes or whatever. Just wonderful on super hot nights where the barometric pressure is just right, that sound carries forever. Our neighbors bought like 3 peacocks, and they're incredibly beautiful animals. But for just like a rooster might crow at like 3 a.m. because the moon is too bright, peacocks like to, I don't know if you would call it a song or whatnot, but if you could just imagine a young woman who's probably a soprano walking at night and is accosted somehow. I don't want to put any horrible things in your head, but peacocks, for no fucking reason whatsoever, just go, ah! 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 And that shit used to make me shit my bed in the middle of the night.
Give us some love, guys. Lock it up. I'm sorry, little mister. Did you shit your bed again?
No.
I think you did. I smelled it from down the hall.
Arthur, I cleaned your sheets 3 times this weekend.
Your daddy cleaned your sheets, Arthur.
I cleaned them by hand because the washing machine's broke, Arthur.
Maybe I shit the bed. Maybe my parents' recent divorce triggered a lot of shit coming out.
We told you it's not your fault.
It's not your fault, Arthur. I just hate your mother.
I love your father. He just hates me.
I hate her so much, Arthur. I love you, but I hate cleaning shit out the bed, Arthur.
I can't even turn around right now, Arthur.
You used to tell me stories about how you met Dad, and that you were a young woman, so of course you were a soprano.
I can't sing no more.
And now you guys are cold. You guys eat Raisin Bran with no milk.
And she's a goddamn alto now. It's not worth it anymore, the beautiful songs you used to sing me.
I just feel like if I'm supposed to be a healthy child, and I'm supposed to go off to college next year. I need strong parents, and if I don't...
Bro, did you shit in my dorm fridge?
Well, how did you hooked up with Miranda? You knew I liked Miranda. I gave you the sign, bro.
Yeah, I saw the sign, bro, but Miranda was all over me. Is that
we're tight. We've known each other for 3 days now. We know our secret handshake.
Yeah.
Hey, I'm so sorry, guys.
There was a sock filled with cum on your door.
That's me.
Classic bones. Classic
bones. Show me how you shit in the fridge, man.
That's a hard. Well, it's hard because it is like a level, right? So what I do is because I have spina bifida. And this is how I put my leg up, right? Uh-huh. And then I have to.
Wait, you're like.
No, I didn't take your food out of the fridge. I didn't see your name on it, at least.
Keith, you're a horrible fucking stepdad. abysmal. I wish my mom wasn't sleeping with you. I wish the two of you hadn't gotten married. I wish I ran off to the carnival when I was younger.
You keep wishing, baby.
I love you, Keithy.
I love you too, baby.
We just see, like, mounds of shit in his mouth.
This doesn't taste right. Did you make this lunch for him?
Hey, I don't want to be here any longer than I have to. Can you just write the check for my tuition and I'll be gone?
You know who's paying for that tuition? The man of the house.
Yeah, so you better show some respect.
Fine, Keith. You.
Give me some more of that, what was this, honey? What did you make it for lunch?
Shit flakes.
Mom, that's the hardest way to shit. You can't just shit flakes at a drop of a hat.
All right, cornflakes. Cornflakes and boys, let's get in here. I need my commercial team on this because we have a huge... We're in the red here. A lot of people are taking our product, cornflakes, and they are shitting in their bowls. They're blowing the shit flakes. It's blowing up on
the top. Are they adding milk to this? And if so, is it skim, oat, or almond?
Milford, thank you so much for being our oldest board member. We want serious pitches.
How about a roll of toilet paper with every box?
Hey, we want to get away from the shit.
Okay? We want to get away. It's selling.
Yeah, but that's what the TikTok is.
It's trending.
Okay, today we're selling. Tomorrow, we're the front page of every newspaper. E. coli. What's the next great pandemic? Cornflakes mixed with shit. That's like the best thing mixed with the lab.
Well, iPods is trending, but not in a good way, right? So we got
Donovan, you crazy son of a bitch. Yeah. What do you got?
I'm just saying, I'm feeling it. Like the time
it's a different yes man, boss.
Yeah, like not all publicity is good publicity. I'm just feeling it. I'm just trying to.
Donovan, I'll see you on the golf course, you piece of shit.
Let me add some Depends to each box.
Milford, your eyes are still on. How adorable is that?
Turn it into like chocolate bits. So, and we call them shit flakes, but it's not really shit. That way, people are like, "This must be the shit flakes I heard of." It's got chocolate. It's like some new, like in your face thing.
So we lean into the shit thing.
But we don't put real shit, so there's no lawsuits, and we can sue people who make fake shit flakes because make real ones with chocolate.
Mama? Did you poo in my flakes?
Of course, sweetheart. For you.
I guess I used to eat things that came from you.
Now I'm gonna bring us closer. I saw all the teens are doing it on TikTok, and I don't want to be a cool mom.
Yeah, man, my parents are pretty bad too. Like, they wouldn't let me borrow the car this weekend.
Oh, yeah? Yeah, my that's, I don't want to give an example.
Notice the thing about this cowboy hat?
Makes you look stupid.
Exactly the point of peacocking. You wear a stupid hat, guess what? Girls notice. Guess what? Girls have to talk to you. Guess what? They feel pressured into talking to you. And that's the only way. Oh, shit.
You know, I was just yee-hawing and then, oh, dang.
Oh, shit. This hat makes my lice itch.
Oh. Fuck, that makes me so wet, wetter than a peacock on a frying pan.
Jeremy's pants. How the fuck did that
really
work?
Well, I mean, I like it. I don't know what I just saw.
Okay, well, I'll let
I live in a Toyota Camry.
Please, give me a hat, Jeremy. Give me a hat.
No, that had to have been a fucking fluke.
No way, man.
There's no way that that would work twice
liar,
in a row.
Liar.
Twice in a row.
Okay, so this Camry's apparently been parked here. Why we gotta check it out? I'm an officer, excuse me.
Oh, 1 second.
Police. Burmese police.
92, sorry. Hey, yeah, can I help you? It's HUB, right? Where I'm about to go shopping. Huh?
I'm sorry, Doc Holliday. I'll be a huckleberry.
Boy, howdy.
You keep carrying on in that Camry, cowboy.
You see lice crawling all over his face.
This man had 12 warrants out for his arrest. He has murder on that list, and you're telling me that...
He was wearing the best hat I've ever seen. He was somehow peacocking in a 92 aluminum box known as the Toyota Camry.
Oh my goodness gracious. I'm sorry, I'm gonna have to... I have no choice but to give you some sort of formal warning.
Give me anything, my blue pants are soaked.
Chief of police, huh?
Yeah. Oh dear God.
Have you ever come so hard that you itch for 8 years?
Maybe you still scratching?
A little bit.
Because you loved me that one night.
Yeah. So. You kind of said like Austin was like this up and coming like tech future, but it's been like, I don't want to be rude, but it's been a lot of people like you, like
trash.
I would say
like hardcore trash.
I want people like blanket people.
Like a lot of people who agree with everything but don't have original ideas.
Yeah,
trash.
Okay, yeah, but I mean, more than that, I don't want you to think like I'm like this, you
know.
I
guess it's confession time. I'm not really from Austin. I'm from Kyle. It's about 15 minutes south.
Wait. You said you took me out of these local spots. You're like, hey, 6th Street's the next thing. They shut it down like a music festival, but there's no main stage. There's a bunch of drug addicts wandering around. That's my vibe.
You were so excited to see Austin, and when I swiped right in that hat.
Kyle, we all know what Kyle's about, because we're all from here. Kyle! Everyone, the Wheat Thins factory is there, and everybody Kyle owns a pair of Heelys. Holy shit!
Just a little intimidated, that's all.
Yeah,
I mean,
what,
there's three of you two.
Shirts on? Sorry, what?
We're not wearing shirts.
No, male nudity doesn't bother me at all.
Not interested at all. It's
you come with us to a camping trip in the woods.
And you expect us to wear our shirts the entire time?
Is it the fact that we all have guns?
It's the fact that you're only wearing guns.
Yeah, that's totally the weird part. Yeah. Like,
what if there's a mountain lion, dumbass?
Are you going to shoot and then fuck it? You gotta climb inside of it like Luke Skywalker?
Wait, okay, hold on. If we were to shoot and fuck a mountain lion,
is that weird?
What would your reaction be? What would your natural reaction be?
You wouldn't like it?
I have no fucking clue. That's why I'm already
Just guess. If I said I fucked one right now, like, what would you say?
I am confident in saying I would not like it, and the fact that you hesitated worries me that I came with you.
Okay, you said it. Bad. Season of Survivor is just.
I don't want to say anything. The guns did throw me. The fact that one guy has a tattoo of a mountain lion with a human juicy ass.
Yeah, it's almost like that Are You Baboon from Calgary.
It is. Yeah. Like, it looks like he's thought about it before.
So you don't want to spank a mountain lion's juicy ass?
And why does I just keep talking about fucking a mountain lion?
I don't know. That's weird, right?
CBS is just so
weird. I don't think it's weird at all.
What I will say is, like, I don't know. It kind of reminds me of, like, when we were in college.
You mean... when I caved that one time? Yeah. I'm still itching.
And I was like, oh my god, who am I?
And then we were pretending to be lions.
Oh my god.
And on a mountain.
I can't remember the last time we, the two of us, didn't sleep in bunk beds. You know?
You said you get turned on by elevation.
I said that, but I was feeling like a distance. I was feeling like I don't know, like just like it was being shy.
Your body language is telling me that you want to get fucked by a mountain lion.
Not a mountain lion, but
what if I was...
Not a mountain lion. Oh my god. I'm married, I can't.
Oh. Oh, you're talking about me. Oh
my god.
This new season of Gogglebox is just weird.
Squid! Squid! Jerry, you're my favorite peacock son. I want to take over a little spot here, out here in the countryside.
God!
You can take over. I don't want you to hurt your throat, Jerry, all right?
It's hurting.
Listen, a real scream comes from the your bird chest, all right?
Go!
Try it.
I don't know if I can, Dad.
Jerry, I believe... Go! Oh, here comes your... That right there's your uncle. I hate this guy.
Hey, Uncle Star, guess what?
What?
Whatever my dad said, I'm going to rule the Peacocks.
It's true. I hate you, Scar. That's why I gave you a scar. You know I lost my feathers in an accident 2 years ago, but I can still scream like the best of them. They're back, baby. Jeremy. Jerry, your first feather. You are now banished from this peacock kingdom, Scott. Get off with you!
I will have my revenge.
I'm sure we'll never see it.
Did you give me a bootleg password to Disney Plus?
Sorry, it's just like...
I get that things like didn't end on good terms, but like, why give me anything?
I thought it'd be funny if you thought you were watching the real stuff, and then you told everybody the Lion King was about fucking peacocks.
Hi, welcome to the world according to Nicolas Cage. Jeff Goldblum's sick right now. I'm filling in with my own show. It's gonna be great.
There's no way this is Aladdin.
Now you're gonna talk about it.
this, okay? Not everyone in their late 20s is gonna marry that person, right? And I feel like you're lashing out, like the fake passwords. The fact that you called me and you're like, hey, your dad, he's like not well, and I had to call my dad, which I haven't talked to in 3 years, by the way.
Oh my God, it was one little prank.
Well, look who it is.
Yeah, Dad, you're on speaker, but you're alone. And I guess I heard that you're not doing well. You came down with something called realinitis.
Yeah, it's real. How'd you hear about it? You don't give a shit about me. You're just off doing your own thing, you big man.
Well, Katie. You met Katie.
Oh, she's so sweet.
Yeah, we went to Six Flags.
She gave me an HGO password.
Hey. Thank you for taking me to Six Flags. It's so romantic.
Oh, absolutely, honey. Today's my day to treat you.
Oh my God. That firework almost just burnt my hair off.
They're much closer than usual.
Hey, you guys want a picture? $49 for a picture? You want a picture? You have
to get it? Can we stop? I'm sorry. I took like a picture actually from me over here.
How much do you charge?
It's $49.
Okay. Hey, you guys want a picture from me?
How much do you charge? Milton?
I don't charge anything. I got my own Instagram. It's, like, it's called Find Where Milton's Sleeping.
I just want a picture from me.
What is your name?
Oh, I pay you to get the pictures.
Okay. Honey, whatever you want to do.
Hey, you guys better be careful. You don't get a picture taken from a picture troll.
Six Flags photographers, jump in here, please. Jump in here.
Fine.
Am I supposed to be at this meeting, or can I go sleep out of the water ride again?
Where's Milton, right? Stay put. All right, guys. You all are attacking the same customers because no one's going to Six Flags anymore. So we have very little foot traffic. Yes, Mike.
I feel like I'm legitimately the only one that's actually doing the job. I take the photo. Thank you.
And you have to get consent. Okay, Patrice? That's not okay now.
I'm not okay.
Oh my God, it's one of those old flash cameras where just the light bulb explodes? Flash everywhere.
It's like, my camera's just one, it's an empty box of detergent you buy at the laundry. It's just empty though.
It's an empty detergent bottle, and inside the detergent bottle is a fleshlight.
Yeah.
Michael, when you applied, you had your own Nikon, and that was the best camera I've seen.
Only camera that you've seen.
No.
David
has a Polaroid.
It's the throwaway kind. I take the pictures and I throw it away. I'm on my 19th camera.
Can we get janitorial in here to sweep up all this glass, please?
And you little creature, what? Oh, God!
I'm still stuck on you think he has a Polaroid. He literally has a sketch patch.
But he rips it off afterwards and gives it to him.
That's not Polaroid, though. I'm the only one
who actually... Polaroid was an act, like a word that meant rip off and give.
Rip off.
Actually, Polaroid was just a company, and I ended up making cameras and film, and then about 1960, 1970, they really solidified themselves with the instant camera. What do you want, Barry?
I said, brother, I want you to come back to Polaroid.
Fuck that, I'm done with corporate America.
You are the best goddamn CEO of that company you've ever seen.
I know, that's why it's failed, and you have the special order.
Google employees, we are getting our ass handed to us by Polaroid. Alphabet is losing money at an astounding rate. Everyone's on Polaroid. Polaroid's the new hot thing.
I mean, I think it has to do with weddings and events and stuff like that. You know, people like the idea of taking a quick Polaroid, maybe with like a little stick that says like,
people love bowls.
Jerry Google. I own junk.
Mr. Google, if I may, what if we just made our own cameras and called them like Polaroid?
I like it.
What if we call it Google Camera? Because like we just put...
It would be named after you, yes, sir.
What about this? What if the camera is on a set of glasses that are so ugly, no human being would ever want them, And if you did have a mop, you'd be like, what is that? It lasts maybe 6 months.
Could we, like, maybe debut those in 2015?
Earlier.
Oh. 2013.
I like it. Me Too movement. I like it.
Oh, so we'll have them out in like 6 months.
So I guess your hair will run in my face, so you're all digital, and I'm analog.
That's right, Google Glass is the future. We just launched a day ago, and I really think that this is going to be, by 2021, everyone's going to have this on their fucking face.
You know
face.
What? Have at it. I did my own market research, and I realized that there's a filter everybody likes, and that's the overexposed Polaroid.
Do you realize when you said that last sentence, a tooth fell out of your face?
That's why I have more.
Jerry, I was wondering if I could answer a few prayers today.
Yes. Father Tony, I have been struggling with my own place in this world. There is this... I want to say... troll person, but I know that's not polite. Milton, and this person who is a loved creature of God is more sludge than human being. He keeps besting me at every corner. He's currently with my wife, my ex-wife, but he's with my wife now. And he walks in there. He's this dynamo, and I know it's not the Lord's way to lust after another man's wife because they're already married. Mm. He has sunk Google Glass. He said more like dork glass, and that stuck. This is 2013, so it's very early meme culture, so the memes don't have to be good. More like dork glass, and it stuck. It's viral.
Well, as you being Jerry Google, and you owning the Lord.
It's me, God. What the hell does Jerry want from me today?
Yeah, Dad, you tell him.
I brought you up to heaven for
Jesus, you have been.
What?
You're supposed to get resurrected off that cross. You've been limping ever since.
Yeah, I thought, like, it adds character. Like, the chicks will really dig it. Like, it makes me a man. I mean, he tried being 33 years old and a virgin.
Huh? Jesus is wearing the ugliest hat you've ever seen.
This is called a sombrero, Dad. I'm very big in Latin America.
All over your face.
Yeah, I thought, you know, if I could carry off on a plague the whole time, people would be like, that Jesus, he's dope.
Listen, I need to sell a resurrection narrative, and I can't have you limping locusts all over your face in this stupid hat.
The hat's not stupid. I will give you the locusts are weird and the limp is weird, but the hat's not stupid.
Jesus is getting ready to give a sermon on the mount, guys.
Jesus.
Everybody,
Jesus.
Ready for this
sermon,
you guys?
Jesus.
You guys
want
some bread?
Signature wings.
Bread. Are those angelic wings?
Yeah.
Oh, no, those are colorful.
Pass the fish. Oh.
All right, listen up, bros. Listen up, bros.
Oh, it's not ending. There's more fish.
Yeah. Be sure to keep, just keep passing the basket
like,
around.
It's like stars coming out of like a magician's hat.
I'm just going to ask a question here. Who wants eternal life?
That sounds pretty good to me, dude.
I want that hat.
Oh, the sombrero?
Yeah, it looks sick.
It's pretty dope, right? Pretty dope. Listen, I think I can get everybody a hat, some eternal life, if all you do is go forth in my name and spread love and joy.
You mean like get a tattoo of you?
You mean like wear a necklace where you die?
Those are all dope ideas.
What if I quoted a book that you've never read and know nothing about? If I resurrect temples and I remind you of the worst day of your life?
Every Sunday.
And what if I take my own personal opinions and say that you said them so that I feel good about myself?
What if I just like, use your ideas to like bully people I don't like?
Yeah. Why is there so much fish?
I'm sorry. Joseph said all of you guys were pescatarian. Are we not pescatarian?
I mean, I like it.
I like steak.
I could use some carbs.
I'm actually a pescatarian.
You could have the fish basket.
Oh, poof. There's a basket full of loaves, guys.
Oh, shit. Yeah.
It's like the Olive Garden up in this. Oh, you will. Oh, maybe you won't. But I will, because I'm eternal, you know?
I thought you said you were going to make us eternal.
No, I asked who wants to be eternal.
That's what's wrong, everybody!